there. I didn't really question it too much until one morning. One morning, I woke up and I was like, I can't budge, and I felt the dread all over me. So I asked my higher power in my head, is there anything dark here? I got the response, no. Something didn't seem right, right? It's like I felt something dark on me. Something wasn't good. But when I said it in my head, I was like, no. It's like, okay. So I did something that took a lot of confidence and courage. I questioned it. So I out loud, my voice says, is there a dark entity here? I got yes. I said, wait a second. I got a no in my head, but then when I verbally said it, I got a different response. Because verbal is our power. This is where we get all of our power from. It's a rule in the combat between light and dark. If you command it, Moses did, right? If you command it, that's where our power is. But with all this lost in translation, we don't know about where our power comes from, and it comes from here. Which then comes to this. So all these things, so as soon as I said it out loud, is there a dark entity here? Out loud, I got yes. So I said, get off me now. And this is what it felt like. It all lifted off me. It felt like literally 100-pound.
Wow.
It felt like 100 pounds was off of me. Literally. At that point, I said, you know what? I've seen darkness, and I know I can stop it through my mouth. So I've been teaching in unique, and this is what's neat. There's many different steps, and I can totally bombard you for hours of conversation here. But my most important thing is I want to give you a gift of awakening, a gift of recognition that you can actually win the battle of light versus dark. It's simple. First thing is recognize that it exists. So in this group, how many of us tend to have racing minds? We tend to not be able to sleep at night. We tend to be negative all the time. We all do. Well, I don't anymore. I got control of that. So what happens is this, is since our power is our voice, all you have to say is one thing, and you're going to have one of three responses. If your mind's chattering, you say this, get out of my head, it's a commandment. Three possibilities, and I've had this all the time with my clients. One, their mind gets quiet. Literally, right after they do that, it's like your brain is quiet. Whoa, that's crazy. I said something and it went away. Other option. No. I said, get out of my head, it's a commandment. And I heard no in my head. Who the heck is saying no? It's not me. And here's the worst. Get out of my head, it's a commandment. You hear curse words. F you. It's very real. Very, very real. So basically, for those of who walked in, you've got this dummy here. This is the dummy that we are. My bad interpretation of a person's body. But basically, through our past, we end up having traumas from our past that were so hurtful and that we never dealt with confronting. For example, I was picked on by bullies. Well, I'm not going to change the fact I was getting picked on by bullies. And it hurt, and it wasn't going to go away. So this, hopefully, after time, is going to kind of get less painful. But the truth is what I did is I left that scar there, and it's been there permanently all the way through my 8 years. Okay? These right here are the reason why we're having these thoughts. It's because these low vibration entities, or jackets, great way to put them, because we all wear jackets, and instead of calling them entities or demons, ooh, I hate that word, we'll call them jackets instead of that. Okay? How did they get in? These are our doorways. These are our mirrors. These are our windows. These are how they get through into us. That's how they start communicating with us and being able to affect our judgment when we're communicating, okay? So the number one step is to get out of my head as a commandment. Now, anyone here, totally honest, anyone have racing thoughts now or your mind's kind of going crazy at the moment? Oh, fantastic. Okay. You want to try something?
Yeah.
I would love it. I would love it. Because like I said, typically, one of three options. Super, super awesome. Now you got to believe in it. So if I so you got a bully, and the bully's right over here, and he's picking on you, and you go, stop it. Right. I don't think so. Back off. Get out of my head. It's a commandment. When you do that, I'm interested to see what happens. So your mind's racing right now. Are you hearing anything before you even utter the words? Sometimes they don't even want you to say the words. They'll try to coach you out of it. Sometimes they'll try to get you. I literally was dealing with someone and helping someone, and he says, they won't let me say it. They won't let you. Who is they? This guy was a crazy guy who beat people up, was in and out of jails, all this kind of stuff. And he literally says, they won't let me say it. He had no idea that he even was a they. All right? So you want to give it a try?
What am I?
Get out of my head. It's a commandment.
Get out of my head. All this negativity. Go.
It's a commandment.
The commandment. Get out of my head. I'm talking to you.
Fantastic. Now, did you hear any responses? Did it get quieter?
Felt like it backed off a bit.
Fantastic. Now, I'm not going to lie to you all. Initially, it was hard. It was very hard. Thank you so much. Give her a hand. That took a lot of courage. It took a lot of courage. That guy who was in and out of jail, the guy who was having issues, he couldn't even utter the words. I tried three times with him, and he got so angry, he shook himself. He's like, ah, I want to beat someone up, and just left. Whatever was in him was so built, so caught into his physiology, that they stirred him up to get him to want to be violent. Now, he wasn't going to be violent on me. I had nothing to be afraid of. I got the angels with me. All right? I'm not afraid to confront. But the thing is that like, they're so strong, they wouldn't even let him say that. So to go back to what happened with her, keep doing it. I remember in the car, I would be, because that's the best place to do it, by the way. Hey, if you can diva up with your favorite song, it's the best place to start screaming your head off. Get out of my head, I'm telling you now! And I'm telling you, after a while, they'll start listening, okay? But you'll see that backing off, and it really is true, okay? So again, we have the doorways that they can enter through. Be aware of, once you recognize that there is a threat out there, and really, truthfully, in life, the biggest combat through dawn of time, before all of our ancestors, before thousands of years ago, it's always been, it seems to be a combat with dark and light, really. It's the only thing that's important in this life, I found out. I don't have to worry about rent. I don't have to worry about, you know, if I have enough money. I don't have to worry about that because I have total faith in the universe. Because once you do recognize that there is a higher power and put all your faith into it, everything you want is going to happen. The only thing that would limit you are any of these unhealed scars that will end up. So those of anyone read The Secret or know about The Secret, Law of Attraction? All right. So you probably, I've heard some people say, it was amazing. And then I've heard other people say, it don't work. Right? Have we all heard the same thing? It's literally one or the other side, okay? Well, the ones who say it doesn't work, it's probably because something was keeping them from being able to attain this spot. Confidence, security, you know, to make it happen. So the most important thing is to recognize that it happens. Also be recognizing your physiology. Because, interestingly enough, notice I put these X's and these circles in different parts of the body. It's because it's interesting that emotions, different types of emotions, are stored in different places on our body. I can't tell you all the different locations, but be aware. Oh, I'm always getting this sore back, okay? I'm always getting this sore shoulder or something like that. And start recognizing that, because most likely that's the dwelling. And then, of course, if you do energy healing, what's intriguing about it, I've actually worked with someone that healed, worked on one of my shoulders. And it was interesting because one session it was in my shoulder, and now my back hurt. The next session he worked on my back, and then it went to a different location. Third session it left. Almost like that whatever was in me, the dis-ease, all right, is intelligent. So we got jackets that seem intelligent. We got disease, which seems intelligent, that's moving around. So basically it's a storage. And the more that you release it, the more that you're going to be able to heal. So again, going back to what I offer is I offer something brand new. It's called Angel Rehab. As I was talking to everyone, for those who just joined into the group, I was a mess. It's okay, I don't mind saying that. I don't mind saying that, because the truth is, if I was given everything from when I was born without any problems, you guys wouldn't have an opportunity to see how someone could literally be on one side in darkness, life is completely dark, to being over here. And that's one of the things that literally I've talked to my angels about, and one of the things they're very proud about with me, and again, I'm not saying this to boast, is they said I was a miracle. I was a miracle because when I was a kid, a teenager, I was literally drawn over to the dark side. I don't remember years of my life. I know I was completely different than my normal behavior. I would be angry. I'd be punching holes in doors, punching holes in wall, yelling at my parents, disrespectful, all this kind of stuff that didn't seem like this is not my character. It's because when you end up getting pulled over to that dark place, I'm just a vessel. I'm being controlled and being manipulated. So through my own courage, I was able to bring myself back to the light, and that's where I've been continually healing my jackets and all this kind of stuff, okay? So I wanted to educate you guys about Get Out of My Head, which is the first step.